lift up your two hands wherever you are. I want every hands in this auditorium lifted. Come on, lift up your hands. Open your mouth, just begin to speak in tongues. Pray your spirit wherever you are. Speak in tongues. Come on, speak in tongues. Yes, Lord, open your mouth and speak in tongues. Come on, speak in tongues, speak in tongues. Come on, speak in tongues.
Jesus.
Wherever you are, say this with me. Heavenly Father.
Heavenly Father.
Shout it like your voice is yours. Heavenly Father.
Heavenly Father.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
Tonight, as my hands are lifted, let my testimonies begin to pour like rain. Say, my father,
whatever it takes tonight,
for my future to be glorious,
tonight,
let that grace, let that power
touch my life.
Say, Lord, this is the last Holy Ghost service.
I declare vehemently.
No power.
No sorcery.
No occultic power.
No witch, no wizard.
Would deny me my blessing. Shout it, my father.
Whatever it takes.
For me to enter. A stupendous blessing.
As my hands are lifted.
I enter by fire.
Devil,
take your hands off my blessing. Tonight is my night. Whether you like it or not. I shall prosper. Whether you like it or not.
I shall be righteous.
In the name of Jesus. Lift up your hands.
The atmosphere is very rich with supernatural aura.
Lift up your hands. In the realm of the spirit, I see no less than 17 angels. And I see every one of those angels carrying a bowl of oil. And I asked the Lord, what meaneth that? The Lord said to me, son, tell my people, in this last Holy Ghost service, everything will be abnormal.
Jesus.
I am here tonight to deliver abnormal blessing to my people.
Amen.
Eternal Father, tonight have your way. Let the entrance of your word bring illumination.
Jesus.
Let as many as will be seated under the sound of my voice, even those who are streaming online, wherever they are, let your blessing be palpable in the name of Jesus. Touch somebody's life. Empower somebody's future. I pray in the name of Jesus that between now and 31st December, give us results that will punish our insults. The devil is a liar. Thank you, Holy Ghost. I pray for clarity in speech tonight. I pray for precision in your repertory word. That tonight, everybody under the sound of my voice, any prophecy that is hanging on anybody's life, tonight it shall come to manifestation. In the name of the Father, the Son, and of the precious Holy Ghost, and everybody will holler a thunderous amen. Come on, let your amen be louder if you are a child of God. Walk to two people, give them a high five, tell them tonight is your night. Tell somebody tonight is your night. Tell somebody whether you like it or not. Tonight is your night. Hallelujah. I said hallelujah. Is somebody blessed to be in the presence of the Lord? You may be seated in heavenly places. Somebody shout fire. Come on, shout it fire. Come on, shout it fire. Come on, shout it fire. Yeah, 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 yeah. Glory to Jesus. Something is cooking in the atmosphere. Yeah, something is cooking. I hear the Holy Ghost say to me, somebody's blessing is on fire. Somebody's miracle is on fire. If you believe you are the one I'm talking about, rise up and shout fire. Yeah, 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 yeah. Sit down. Tonight, before we go into the realms of the intrinsic word, I want you to help me. Let's appreciate the mama of the house. Come on, let's appreciate the premier lady of the house, my baby. Come on, appreciate my inestimable wife. You are not clapping. No. Glory to Jesus. Thank you, thank you. I also want to acknowledge the presence of Reverend Ochre. Let's appreciate him. God's ambassadors, come on, appreciate him. Appreciate him. Reverend Ochre, a very dear friend to the house. We also want to appreciate Reverend Enoch from London. Let's appreciate him. He's also a very dear friend to the house. Hallelujah. Well, one of the worshippers in town, you know, you can't mention maybe 10 very popular worshippers in town and not mention Jeshurun Ochre. Come on, let's put our hands together and appreciate him. Thank you, thank you, thank you. We appreciate your coming. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Let's appreciate Nana Jaman. Let's appreciate him. Let's appreciate Jamin as well. The choir, Minister Welbeck, and everybody. Come on, put your hands together for them. Appreciate my pastors. Appreciate them. The resident pastor is here. The associate pastors are also here. Amen. Are you ready for tonight? You see, I'm very titillated tonight. Not because tonight is the last Holy Ghost service for the year. But I'm very, you know, titillated because God told me in secret that tonight, even the least in this house, by the time we are sharing benediction, your testimony will be in your hands. If your amen is the loudest, your testimony will be special. Are you with me at all? So, I want to entreat everybody. I want you to be very, very attentive. Tell somebody be attentive. Yes, I want everybody to be very meticulous. I want you to follow me meticulously because something will touch your life tonight. I'm telling you, everything about tonight's service is prophetic. Right from the ab initio, as I'm teaching the repertory word, till the time of benediction. Hear me. Everything that transpires in this auditorium is prophetic. Why? Because it's speaking into your future. Listen, your future is better than your present. Am I talking to somebody at all? Tell somebody my future is superior to my present. Tonight, I'm speaking on a message I've titled The Mystery of the Blessing. Somebody shout, the mystery of the blessing. Come on, talk to me. The mystery of the blessing. Shout it, oh God. Tonight, I receive my blessing. Shout it, my Father. Tonight, I receive my blessing. Say, in this month of December, I receive my blessing. Shout it, my finances will be blessed. My marriage will be blessed. My career will be blessed. Good people will enter my life. If you are not shouting, it will leave you behind. Shout it, good people will enter my life. Maybe you don't know, but our theme for this month is the month of consecration and blessing. Shout it, I receive my blessing. You receive a blessing. I say you receive a blessing. You receive a blessing. Yeah. Whether the devil likes it or not, the blessing is your portion. Somebody shout, the blessing is my portion. Come on, shout it 3 times. The blessing is my portion. The blessing is your portion, sir. The blessing is... Listen, if after this service, God is going to give you a car, if God is going to give you a house, if God is going to give you an apartment, it comes from the blessing. Are you with me at all? So the blessing of the Lord is the vehicle that conveys or transports the goodness of God into your life. Tonight, I prophesy with my eyes open. Everyone under the sound of my voice, your blessing is coming to you. I say your blessing is entering your life. May 10 of you receive financial blessing. May 20 of you receive financial blessing. I prophesy tomorrow by this time, money you didn't bargain for, promotion you didn't bargain for, favor you didn't bargain for, it is entering your life. Rise up and shout, I take it by fire. Shout it, I take it by fire. Give somebody a high five. Tell the blessing is your portion. Say it from the depths of your heart. The blessing is my portion. The blessing is your portion. Listen. The opposite of blessing is curse. Are you with me at all? You are either blessed or you are under a curse. But thank God tonight, you and I, we are not under a curse. I said tonight, we are not under a curse. We are under a supernatural blessing. I speak over your life. Anything that delayed in your life, may the blessing of the Lord airlift it into your life. I don't care what you were denied of in January. I don't care what you were denied of in October. But tonight, a certain blessing is coming to you. Somebody shout, I catch it by fire. Turn your Bibles to Deuteronomy chapter 11. Let me show you something. Deuteronomy chapter 11. Let's open some things. The verse number 26. You are either blessed or you are under a curse. There is no negotiation about that. You can't be in equidistant. You can't be in the middle. You are either blessed or you are under a curse. Are you with me at all? That is why tonight I'm teaching on the mystery of the blessing. Look at it. Can you see it? Deuteronomy chapter 11. Let's read from verse 26. Glory to Jesus. Are you there? Somebody shout Deuteronomy. May Jehovah dethrone your enemies tonight. I say, may Jehovah dethrone your enemies tonight. Behold, I set before you this day. Can you see that? A blessing and what? Talk to me. A blessing and what? Verse 27. A blessing if ye obey the commandments of the Lord your God, which I command you this day. Verse 28. And a curse if ye what? Will not obey the commandment of the Lord your God, but turn aside out of the way which I command you this day to go after other gods which ye have not known. So if you obey God, you inherit a blessing. If you disobey God, you inherit a curse. Are you with me or are you with me at all? It's either this one or that one. Hear me, anybody here that because of disobedience, because of unfaithfulness, you are not enjoying the blessing of God. Tonight, I place a demand on the supernatural. May God tamper justice with mercy and carry you from the place of curse and envelope you with his blessing. Somebody shout, I receive my blessing. It's either you are carrying a blessing or you are carrying a curse. Are you with me at all? If you obey God, you are blessed. If you disobey God, you are under a curse. So you cannot be in the middle. Are you with me at all? Tell somebody you cannot disobey God and expect a blessing. If you honor God, you obey instruction, God blesses you. That is why tonight I pray that the grace for total obedience in this season, may that grace come upon you. I say, may that grace come upon you. You know my fervent desire for you, that everybody under the sound of my voice, after this service, God will bring some superfluous blessings upon you. Even your enemies will be at peace with you. Am I talking to somebody at all? Can I prophesy over you? I prophesy with my telescopic eyes that between now and next week, by this time, God will give you a miracle that is not already in your life. Somebody shout, I receive it. God will give you. Somebody shout, I'm waiting for my blessing. So it's either you are blessed or you are cursed. Are you with me at all? That is why you see people who are always disobeying. You know, people are always undermining. People who don't honor the man of God. People who don't honor leadership. People who are always holding secret caucuses. They are denigrating leadership. They are a problem to the vision of the house. They can never enjoy blessing. In fact, you are in a ministry, you don't give offering. You are in a ministry, you don't pay tithe. My dear, you are treading on a very dangerous ground. Very dangerous ground. Are you with me at all? You are treading. You are likely to inherit a curse, not a blessing. He said, if you obey, a blessing follows you. If you disobey, a curse. I didn't say it. This is God speaking. This is God speaking. I showed you this text just to let you know you cannot be in the middle. You are either in the place of blessing or you are in the place of a curse. But thank God tonight, anything called a curse over your life is broken. Anything that has brought limitation to your destiny is broken. Am I talking to somebody at all? Get ready for unusual impact. Get ready for unusual results. When the blessing comes upon you, you become another man. Listen. It is the blessing of God that when a man or a woman carries, that people favor you. When your life has no blessing, nobody favors your life. I'm telling you, if nobody is thinking about how can I bless you, what can I do? If somebody should call you and tell you, for some time, I've not given you a gift. And because of that, I cannot sleep. You know why? It's because you carry a blessing. When you are a carrier of blessing, people cannot sleep because of your sake. Am I talking to somebody? 3 days ago, somebody called me, sent me some pictures of cars. He said, man of God, it's been a while. It's been a while. I think I need to do something. When you carry a blessing, people will wake up and say, it's been a while. Am I talking to somebody? I prophesy over you. You will live in a house you didn't build. You will drive a car you didn't buy. Are you receiving the blessing at all? Rise up and shout fire. Shake your legs, shout fire. Jump on your feet, shout fire. Listen, if you are not blessed, nobody remembers you. It is the blessing of the Lord that makes people remember you. It is the blessing. Stop saying some people are wicked. Stop saying some people are bad. Stop bad-mouthing people. The problem is you don't carry a blessing. If you carry a blessing, people will favor you. People have died and gone. Today, we still celebrate them. Florence Nightingale, she died many years ago. But today, we still celebrate her. Madame Teresa died how many years ago? Billy Graham is dead. But anytime you mention his name, there is celebration. Are you with me at all? So when you carry a blessing, even when you are dead, people still sing your praise. I prophesy to you, the blessing nobody has carried in your family, the car nobody has driven in your family, the house nobody has built in your family, I see no less than 20 people, they are entering your life. They shall bless you with that blessing. Somebody shout, I receive it. Somebody shout, I am blessed. So you need the blessing of the Lord. Are you with me at all? It is the blessing of the Lord that will make people look for you. Are you with me? When you carry blessing, God blesses, God sends people your way. You see, when you don't carry blessing, good people bypass you. I'm telling you, it's good to pray, but after you have prayed, believe God for the blessing. Because if you don't carry the blessing, my dear, good people will bypass you. You will see promotion man coming. When they meet you, they go past you. Come, you will see financial favor coming. When they see you, they go past you. Why? Because your life is devoid of blessing. But I prophesy with my telescopic eyes. After tonight, no good thing will bypass you. I said, no good thing will bypass you. Somebody shout, I receive my blessing. So you need the blessing of the Lord. In superfluous dimension, the blessing of the Lord must increase in your life and in my life so that people can locate us. You see, when you are not blessed, you become envious and jealous of others' blessing. I'm telling you, a lot of the envy in the church is because the people are envious. They don't have blessing. If you are a carrier of blessing, you will not be jealous of another person. Somebody gave a testimony of a house, you are sad. Somebody gave a testimony of a new car, you are angry. Somebody said, I am getting married. You are angry. What is wrong with you? It's because you don't have a blessing. My dear, the way you are going, if care is not taken, you will inherit a curse. But I pray for you. A curse will not be your portion. I say a curse will never be your portion. the blessing of the Lord will come upon you. Somebody shout, I receive my blessing. 27 verse 30. Quickly. Genesis 27. The verse number 30. Let's read it together. And it came to pass. As soon as what? Blessing Jacob. What happened? Listen, Jacob received the blessing. He has scarcely gone far. His brother Esau came. The question is, what did Jacob receive? Because, listen. By the time Esau came, the material substance was still intact. The gold was still intact. The cattle was still intact. Are you with me at all? So what did Jacob receive? That he had not gone too far. That when Esau came, the father said, your brother has taken the blessing. Because at the time the father was saying that, the material blessing or the material substance was still in the compound. So what did he take away? He took the blessing. So the question is, what is the blessing? The blessing is any pronouncement from the word of God over any man's life. Anytime. You see, blessings come from words. Somebody shout, blessings come from words. Shout it, blessings come from words. Blessings come from words. Blessings come from the pronouncement of words through the word of God. Jacob's father called him. He said, oh boy, kneel down. Then he released words upon his life. Then when he had not gone too far, Esau also came. He said, your brother has taken the blessing. Oh. So every blessing is by communication of words. Are you with me at all? As much as words communicate blessings, so curses are communicated by words. Are you with me at all? If a man of God is happy with you, and he blesses you, it will come to pass. Oh, I'm telling you. Isaac was a man of God. He blessed Jacob. It came to pass. In the same vein, if a man of God is anointed and ordained by God, and you offend him, and he curses you, it will come to pass. Why? The Bible said a curse without a cause will not stand. Which means a curse that has a cause will stand. Tell somebody, be careful. Be careful. Be careful. Be careful the lies you talk about your man of God in secret. Be careful the lies you talk about your leaders in secret. Be careful. Be careful. You may think you are justified in your actions. But my dear, gradually a curse is coming upon you. Every blessing is communicated by words. Every blessing. So tonight, if I stand here and I tell you you are blessed, it's a very serious statement I'm making. Are you in the house at all? If I tell you tonight you are blessed, it's a very serious statement. Why? Because I'm speaking words over your life. And anytime I tell you are blessed, heavenly audacity will confirm my authority on earth. And I announce to you after tonight, you are blessed in the name of Jesus. I say you are blessed in the name of Jesus. An anointing is coming upon you. Some power is coming upon you. Some favor is coming upon you. Rise up and shout, I take it by fire. The blessing is as a result of words. Words. Anytime I've had the privilege of hanging around men of God that carry unction, I don't ask them for money. No, I don't ask for favor. I ask for the thing that makes them who they are. There is an engine that makes them who they are. There is something they carry. Are you with me at all? Listen, it is the blessing of the Lord upon a man's life that makes him or her escape some perils of life. Sometimes you wonder how some people enter problem and they come out. You wonder how some people, every day, something evil is coming. They dodge, they swerve. Why? Because they carry the blessing. Sir, there is no way the man that has a land and the man that has no land is the same. Am I talking to somebody at all? The blessing is by words. by words. I wondered why Isaac didn't give Jacob camel, didn't give him horses, didn't give him gold, but he gave him the blessing. Listen, some of you are here, maybe you are looking for a car, you are looking for a house. Yes, God will give you, but they are products of the blessing. Once the blessing comes upon you, it's a magnet. Anything that is a missing link in your life, tonight, as you receive the blessing, the magnet of the blessing you carry will pull those things into your life. Can I prophesy over you? Anybody that is believing God for marriage, because you are living here with a blessing, next year by this time, you will not just be married, but you'll be carrying your first child. Am I talking to somebody at all? Receive that blessing. Receive that blessing. Listen, when you carry blessing, my dear, promotion will locate you. I'm telling you, when you carry a blessing, your children will go to good schools. Your children will enter university and graduate with flying colors. Why? Because you carry a blessing. You carry a blessing. You carry a blessing. When you carry a blessing, it's very tangible. When you see a blessed man, don't you see? When you see a man, a woman that is blessed, won't you know that this one is blessed? I'm telling you, it is very vivid. Listen, enough of you celebrating others. After tonight, your own celebration has come. You have escorted people to the airport for far too long. After tonight, others will escort you to the airport. Am I prophesying to somebody? You have always been at people's wedding. After tonight, God will give you your own marriage. I prophesy to 16 women that are desperate for a marriage. May God bring that man into your life. Receive it in the name of Jesus. I hear the Lord say, there are some men here. God is giving you a new job. That old job is being taken. God is bringing you a better job. Receive that anointing. Receive that blessing. Rise up and shout, I receive it. God will give you a better job. When you carry the blessing. Give me Deuteronomy 28. Let's look at something. The verse number 4. Deuteronomy 28. Somebody shout the mystery of the blessing. Blessed shall be the fruit of thy body. And the fruit of thy what? And the fruit of thy cattle. And the increase of thy kind. Listen, when you carry blessing, it is the blessing that makes you a colossal, achiever. It is the blessing of the Lord that makes you an acquirer. If you don't carry God's blessing, you can never achieve. You can never inherit. You can never acquire. I prophesy over you. Because you carry the blessing, God will make you an acquirer. I say God will make you an acquirer. I prophesy in this house. May God raise real estate developers. I say may God raise end time billionaires. May God raise end time billionaires. Who am I talking to? If you believe you are the one, rise up and shout, I am the one. Every colossal inheritance, every colossal achievement is tied to the blessing. If you carry blessings, you will acquire something in life. People who don't acquire are not blessed. Why should you rent a house forever? Why should you be a tenant forever? Who said you cannot drive a good car? Is prosperity the native of certain people? You too, you own a house in airport. I'm prophesying, you own a house in East Legon. You own a house in good places in Accra. If you are not shouting, I don't know why you came. But I prophesy to you, the blessing of God in this atmosphere, may that blessing come upon you. I say, may that blessing come upon you. Next year by this time, you'll be living in East Legon. Next year by this time, you own an apartment at the airport. Next year by this time, the places you thought you will never go, I see you enter Dubai. I see you enter Hong Kong. I see you enter Europe. Receive that blessing. Receive grace to be an acquirer. Somebody shout fire. Shake your legs, shout fire. Shake your body, shout fire. Jump on your feet, shout fire. It is the blessing of the Lord that makes you an acquirer. Give somebody a high five. Tell the person, I will be an acquirer.
Every parent is happy to see a child that is blessed. Talk to me. Every parent is happy when he or she discovers that his or her child is blessed. You think my mother is sad? No. When your son is a global preacher, casting out devils on major platforms, you think my mother is sad? My mother is happy. Why? Because you are blessed. You think Pastor James's family, they are sad? He's a resident pastor of House of Consecration. He's a dangerous worshiper and a preacher. And you think his family will be sad? Every parent is happy when they discover that their children are blessed. Are you with me at all? Any child that is always bringing problem, enigma, confusion, parents don't like to talk about that child. So a few years ago, I was watching Deutsche Welle, DWTV, and there was a documentary about the youngest golfer. The youngest golfer. Hi-ya-ya. This boy went into a car shop, Ferrari shop, and bought a car that cost $200,000. A boy of 22 years. 22 years. Bought a car. For the mother and father, they were snapping pictures with him. Ha. Why would your parents not snap picture with you when you are successful? So, when God blesses you, when you enter your family, everybody is happy. I prophesy over you this Christmas, because of you, every member of your family will rejoice. I say every member of your family will rejoice. May blessings run to you. May blessings run to you. I'm telling you. When you carry blessing, you bring joy to your family. You become a sukkah to your family. When my brother became a minister of state, do you think my mother was sad? When mommy started doing business and succeeding, do you think a mother will be sad? Every mother rejoices. Gideon, you are a protocol to one of the best men of God in this country. You think your mother will be sad? Macho, will your mother be sad? Opportunity. Can I prophesy to you? 22 years old boy, 200,000. Those of you who have children, may your children bring you honor in the name of Jesus. Those of you who don't have children, in the future I prophesy, may your children bring you honor. May your children bring you honor. May your children bring you honor. If your amen is the best, your own case will be special. Listen. Last year, when Isley was picking prizes, my daughter, unfortunately, I couldn't go. But when mommy was there and they announced that she was the best student in her class, my dear, I was home, but I was jumping. The best. The mother was jumping at the school. Me, that was not there, I was also jumping. Why? Because he has brought joy. Listen, if your parents are alive, your parents are alive, you will bring them joy. I said, God will so bless you. You will build a house for your mother. You will build a house for your father. You will buy a car for your mother. You will buy a car for your father. Receive it in the name of Jesus. Somebody shout, I take it by fire. It is the blessing of the Lord. Blessed without being in the field. Blessed when you don't carry blessing, you don't acquire. I see an angel taking something from me and distributing to people. I don't know how many of you are desperate for a miracle, but tonight I see a mass distribution of blessing. Receive it in the name of Jesus. Listen. The reason why nobody is giving you a gift is because you don't have a blessing. But you know what's going to happen? The people that carry blessing that you are happy for tonight, their blessing will smear on you. I said their blessing will smear on you. May the blessings of CEOs smear on you. May the blessings of real estate developers smear on you. May the blessings of anointed prophets, anointed apostles, anointed pastors, let it smear on you. Receive it
Receive it. Somebody shout fire.
It was me on you. Listen. Listen. You can never be a son. You can never be a son in this house and remain poor. I'm prophesying. You can never be a bona fide son in this house. Sir, I am not poor by the grace of God. Sir, I am not broke by the grace of God. If I can never be broke, I prophesy to you, you will never be broke in your lifetime. I say you will never be broke in your lifetime. Somebody shout, I reserve it. Do you know it is the blessing of the Lord that makes you a giver? I'm telling you, people who are not blessed, they are very calculative. People who are not blessed, they work out mathematics. When it's time for giving, they are quoting Pythagoras theorem. They are looking for algebra. What is wrong with you? It's because you don't have a blessing. When you are blessed, you become a dangerous giver. In Deuteronomy 16, the verse 17, the Bible says, every man, according to what you have, give. According to the blessing of the Lord, he has given to you. So it is the blessing of God that makes you a giver. Listen, listen, listen. When a man is blessed, money doesn't fill his pocket. Can I preach? When a man carries blessing, money doesn't fill your pocket. Money fills your mind. When a man is blessed, the money may not be in his pocket, but the money is in his mind. Do you know, this is not pride. At my level today, it will be an insult for me to take 5 cedi and give as a standard offering to another person. That is a good seed. That is a good offering. But to me, it is an insult to the grace of God. To drop 5 Ghana cedi. To somebody, too, it's an insult to drop 2 cedi. It's an insult to drop 1 cedi. Why? Because the blessing of the Lord has made you too large. Somebody say, I'm large. Let money fill your mind. In Isaiah chapter 54, the verse number 4, the Bible says, enlarge the place of thy tent. Let me teach a little. Go to the place that says, enlarge the place of my tent. 4. No, not that one. Go to verse 2 quickly. 54 verse 2 quickly. Isaiah 54 verse 2. Enlarge the place of thy tent. Listen to me. Listen to me. The cars, the money, the promotion. That is the tent. The tent in this scripture. This scripture is a metaphor. The tent there is not talking about physical tent. The tent there speaks of the blessings of God. You know, money is a product of the blessing. A good wife is a product of the blessing. So the Bible said, enlarge the place, not the tent. The tent is not our prerogative. The tent is not our responsibility. The cast, the money, the favor, it is God's responsibility. But God is saying, enlarge the place. Where the blessing will sit, enlarge it. So what is the place? The place is simply your mind. Sir, if your mind is poor, God can never prosper you. Instead of everybody that is blessed is juju. Everybody that is blessed is occulting. Are you telling me God cannot prosper people? Mr. Otumba, bring him. Let him sit here. Bring Mr. Otumba, let him sit there. Listen to me. Let money fill your mind. You may not have physical cash today. Sir, let money fill your mind. Somebody said, money will fill my mind. He said, enlarge the place. Let your mind proliferate. Let your mind increase. Fill your mind with cash. Start behaving like a big man, and you will become a big man. As a man thinketh, so is he. If you think like a poor person, you'll be poor. But if you think like Bill Gates, and you think like Dangote, and you think like Prophet Kingsley, I prophesy to you, that shall be your portion. I said, that shall be your portion. Stop thinking poverty. Tell somebody, stop thinking poverty.
listen, if you continue to be a destitute or you continue to be an impoverished person, you will never bring joy to your family. Okay. Say, honey, this Christmas, I want to buy some dresses. Oh, you like dresses? You like dresses? Your children will come to you. Daddy, mommy, we are tired. We want to enjoy conflicts. This Christmas, conflicts in here. So Burkina, Alewanyo, Burkina, and no dear, yeah. Ubufuana the full as wakan. When your children come to you, say, Daddy, we are tired of Fula. We are tired of Burkina. We want quicker house. He said, for where? It's poverty. Your mind is poor. You don't carry a blessing. My dear, stop telling your wife, baby, I love you. Babe, love is a verb. It's not a noun. If you love somebody, show it. Take your wife to a shop. Tell her, baby, today I want to spoil you. I prophesy to a certain man. May financial blessings come upon you. Your wife will be happy with you. Somebody shout fire. Shout fire. Shake your leg. Shout fire. In some families, my goodness, in some families, when it's getting to Christmas, you see their children, they will come. Mommy, Daddy, we want to go to Germany. Mommy, this Christmas, we don't want to go to Ohio. We want to go to Hamburg. Then wife too will come. Baby, I'm tired of Ohio. I don't like Hamburg. I want to go to Hong Kong. Then the man too is blessed. He said, honey, you want Hong Kong? My children, you want Hamburg? Don't worry. You will call the ticketing woman. Quickly do a round trip. We are going to Hong Kong. From Hong Kong we'll come. May that be your portion. I say, may the blessing come upon you. Somebody shall fire. You think the way mommy is loving me is because every day I'm just telling, I love you, I love you. And you are not demonstrating the love. Upon a tumor bar, na milk as some of fear. They said they will be heavy. And no people will fear. Common ideal milk. So people must die. I've said it before. When Nestle decided to change the way they make milk, who says they say milk? No, Omutuni say Nestle Ghana. One said of mine. Somebody came on Facebook angry with Nestle company. I was wondering what his problem was. He said, "Hi, I didn't person who see us. I didn't hear. I didn't have milk near two. They said they want to have. Who share an answer? Now I'm saying, why are you crossing it? Oh here. Anti. What's the more cost robot form? Messan Taneno. No, I too chain. No, they are true here. Poverty. I prophesy to you, God will take you beyond that level. I say, God will take you beyond that level. Somebody shout, I carry a blessing. Listen. Blessings are sweet. Blessings are sweet. I am a holiness revivalist to the core. But I will not tell you poverty is good. Sir, poverty is a bad thing. Become a giver. God will bless you. The more he blesses you, the more you give. In Luke chapter 6, the verse number 38, he said, give and you shall receive. Press down, shaking together, running over, shall men give to you. So any man that is blessed, God will orchestrate people. Can I talk to somebody? In the next 3 days, people will meet you and give you pounds. I said, somebody will meet you and give you dollars. Somebody will meet you and give you euros. Am I prophesying at all? Receive that blessing. Receive that blessing. Receive that blessing. So if you are not blessed, you can never be a giver.
So start giving. Start giving. Be a dangerous giver. Be a dangerous giver. Don't apologize when you give. I can tell you for a fact, by the grace of God, I am not at this apogee in ministry because I'm a good preacher. Not even because I can prophesy. I am at this level because I'm also a dangerous giver. Check in the life of anybody that is a true giver. They can never go down. The blessing on the lives of people who are givers, it will always heighten. It will always increase. It will always proliferate. I prophesy to you, you are after tonight, you are becoming a dangerous giver. I say you are becoming a dangerous giver. Receive that grace in the name of Jesus. I just heard in the spirit, a certain woman, in 10 years from today, the grace to be a millionaire is coming upon you. I heard it for a certain woman in this house. You become a millionaire in the name of Jesus. Receive it in the name of Jesus. Give me Proverbs chapter 10, the verse 22. I'm rounding up. You see, I'm just showing you the power of the blessing. I've not even entered how you can get the blessing. Don't worry. I will close you very soon. Look at it. Let's read it together. The blessing of the Lord. No, why are you rushing? The blessing of the Lord. Comma. Can't you see the punctuation? Why are you in a hurry to read the Bible? He said, the blessing of the Lord, comma. Somebody shout, the blessing of the Lord, comma. Oh, I should end it here. Talk, should I end the message here? You want me to go further? The thing that sweet you too much. You want to be blessed. Listen, there's coming a time in your house, eh? When you look at the cars, when you look at the cars, the list will be a Jaguar. I'm prophesying to you. Oh, Jesus. I told you, I was praying for a governor in Nigeria, in Delta. I was praying for a man that was going to stand for election as a governor. When I entered his house, just run. The man took me to one of his houses, not all, just one. When I entered the compound, I saw not less than 50 cars. Just run. The cheapest car I saw, God is my witness, was a Range Rover. Dead, black, white, blue, green. Mention the colors. And if he buys a 4x4 that is powerful, he will look for a saloon that is equally powerful. So that the days he doesn't want to be high, he will drive the one high. The days he wants to be low, he will go for the lower. I asked him, I said, sir, why all these cars? You know, Pitobi. I said, why all these cars? You know what he told me? He said, all these cars are under divine punishment. He said he has been poor before. He told God, if you bless me, anything that punish me, I'll punish it. Can I talk to somebody? They said a single bedroom, a table. They said a microwave. This is what we're doing. Because you'll be there. After tonight, your story will change. I say your story will change. Your story will change. Receive an anointing to be blessed. Somebody shout, I receive it. Can I prophesy? Listen. In your lifetime, you too, you will punish cars. You will punish houses. Receive it in the name of Jesus. Go back to my text. He said, the blessing of the Lord. Comma. You know why? You know why there's a comma? Because he now wants to introduce the content of the blessing. He wants to introduce the power of the blessing. That is why he said the blessing of the Lord. Comma. It maketh rich. And what happens? Listen. When you enter somebody's house and they are calling uncle, they are calling auntie, they are calling brother, they are calling sister, we have not eaten for days. We are hungry. Help us. That is not the time to call them. Come and let's pray. Master, open fire to do. The problem is not prayer. Prayer is good. But they are telling you, who told you before you came, they hadn't prayed. I come to Nipa. Wabom fire. Nyamite waba. Usu tuha. We say, let's pray. I don't know three more things.
enter a house and they are suffering, at least by the time you are leaving, if you are a carrier of blessing, that family shall start rejoicing. Am I talking to somebody? Listen, after tonight, if you didn't have blessing on your life, any family will enter because of the blessing coming upon you. You'll be a problem solver to that family. You'll be an answer to that family. Receive it in the name of Jesus. Somebody shout, I receive it. The blessing of the Lord, it will make you rich. Tell somebody, start behaving like a rich man. Big man. Big woman. Are you with me at all? Go and ask for all these beautiful apartments. Go and ask them, how much is this apartment selling? They say, okay, this is $250,000. Okay, is that all? Do you have another type? They are wondering, do you have money? Don't forget that one. The money is in my spirit. The money is in my mind. Am I talking to somebody? When we close from service, somebody is reversing. Go to the person. Tell the person, how much did you buy this car? I think I want to buy something nicer than this one. Do you have an idea how much? Am I talking to somebody? If you can start behaving like a big man and a big woman, God will orchestrate it in your life. Somebody shout, I take it by fire. A woman sat in marriage counseling class for 6 months. On the last day of the counseling, Bishop James asked the woman, where is your husband? He said, my husband will appear, sir. My husband will appear. The bishop didn't laugh because the bishop knew the woman had faith. The day they were dissolving the class, the husband appeared. That is why I'm telling you, you could be sitting here as a pauper. Maybe a child, you'll be decreting. Maybe tomorrow, you don't even know whether you'll be kicked out of that house or not. But I'm here to tell you, to him that believeth, Mark chapter 9 verse 23, all things shall be possible. I prophesy over you, somebody will surprise you in the coming week. I said somebody will surprise you in the coming week. Receive it in the name of Jesus. Now quickly, let me show you how you can get the blessing. Are you ready? Maybe I should end it here. An answer. And I'm even my Enoch, not to us. Do you want to know how to get it? You want the machine? Catch your people and say, obey you what? Obey. 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 Unkwa unampaso da. The privilege of lying on your own when you be down. The biao show being chain. Did that you cry a man? What do you cry no one more? Because I did do mu. Once I make you not TC for more, you're suspect. Juko hotel, cry near the autumn passwa. What me that half? What do you mean spread on? Because Debbie. Debbie, I told Debbie, "Nanya Mishrawa, when you are blessed, you can snow." I'm telling you, "Say Nanya Mishrawa, now snow, eh Mishra." Who said, "Obi Oha or snow, enyom ne de"? Ne snoring, no de. Who said, "Escafo snow"? Obi Oso or snow na buof. Eh Ohiya. Edeka. Edeka. May God bless you after tonight. I said, may God bless you after tonight. Rise up and shout fire. Jump on your feet, shout fire. Shake your body, shout fire. Throw your legs, shout fire. Give somebody a high five. Tell the person, afa. Catch and say, me sick and afa. Catch and say, me here, dear, and afa. Listen, I was about to go to the airport to catch a flight from Kumasi to Accra this afternoon. Then my son, resident pastor, sent me a message. I said, Bishop, and you may have a car dedication. I said, tear rubber. We said,
Inshira enye dana. Eye busan. Wo de ohun so bi enye inshira na aka hun sam ntina wo de ma no. Listen, so when ni nyima obi dia, unye bi da. I'm telling you. Unye bi da. Joshua, inshira de. I'm telling you. Masa, who shia David Abusan? He didn't know say, I shall not die, but live. Man is in a warfare. David, you quote this scripture now. I say a warfare prayer. I shall not die, but live. When was he can you person who die? When I catch you say David, then come in. David was a blessed man. So he said, I shall not die. Why? Because life is sweet. Masa, life is sweet. As you walk a buffet, oh, then you are in a sasso. No, who do you know? A whole abitinio. Jai crass a seminal crowd, what the abitinio? And you know, Musso is a buffet, it will be a diana. There be. Who's all here to crown pie? Two tenas near the men who tore was a moon near the Anania friend a la carte. Oh, crass a seminal. Umpie. Umpie. We know we be here. Breakfast. Breakfast, pa. Yeah, oh, yeah, yeah. Breakfast table. We are in a sasso. With this, obisa, your chin cushions. Money me the end of you all. We must watch. You know what? And I'm call Papa Ninja. And I'm what was. Uja fude na no obisa. No osiri. Ohia nyo. Eh ya. Uzo bi de rice and chicken na o ka ho nsem, na mo be yare. Na mo be yare. Uzo bi de Chinese be de omo ye. Na o say ne ma no, na o say senior. It is the blessing of the Lord that maketh rich. There is no wife, there is no woman I know, a wife, that when your husband is blessed and your husband is blessing you, you have a problem. Would they say, oh, God, it could do you what? Would me fool, do this is why I'm ticking. No one check it. No one friend. Maybe a Samson fool in a main panel. Samson fool. And now you be an SWAT. I didn't know. When you're missing our, what we discover good card, so what's where they are there? Far away. You have a soul to air, sir, catch them, and I'm in San Fabinuso. Blessings are sweet. This is our month of blessing. This is our month of consecration. As God is consecrating you, God is pouring blessings upon you. Give me Hebrews chapter 6. Let's conclude this thing. Hebrews chapter 6. Hebrews chapter 6. Let's go to verse 7. Hebrews chapter 6. Let's go to verse 7. I want to show you how you... There are several ways you can get the blessing. Are you with me at all? The ways you can get the blessing is very copious. But I want to show you one way. Somebody shout one way. One way. Very simple. For the earth, which drinketh the what? The rain that cometh often upon it and bringeth forth what? Continue. Unse will read in grass. Unse will cast himself big man. Unse will be people who are blessed. They don't talk fast. They take their time. Excuse me, what are you saying? Is everything okay? Sit down, my dear. Sit down. You see, that's how a big man behaves. Obi a comedy no kasantem dudu. When you are not blessed, you talk fast. I'm going home. I said, if you are no obi ko. Ori mfi unsesada. Since you became a child, you have never given anybody tip. Tip. You go and eat. When they bring your change, you say, take unye bita. It's poverty. 50 pesos can make you swear. So one for me, sika. Hey, 50 pesos. me that scripture.
Bring forth what? Herbs. Meat for them by whom it is dressed. Receiveth what? From God. Continue, verse 8. But that which beareth thorns, chuku chuku, nkase, and what? Is what? Is what? The thorns and the breast is rejected and is near unto what?
Hey, you see, everything in this scripture is metaphoric. It's a metaphor. Somebody shall metaphor. You see, the earth in this scripture, the verse 6, go to the verse 6, the verse 7, I beg your pardon. The earth there, it's not talking about physical earth. The earth there is a representation of children of God. So the Bible is saying the children of God that receive the rain often. So what is the rain? The rain is not physical rain. The rain is the word of God. Anytime you see rain in the Bible, sometimes it speaks of God's word. Other times it speaks of the Holy Ghost. But in this scripture, it's talking about the word of God. So how do I receive the blessing? The earth, which is you and I. Anytime we receive the word of God, as we keep receiving the word of God, faith cometh by hearing. Romans 10:17. Faith cometh by hearing and hearing. As we keep receiving the word of God, we are provoked. Then immediately we are provoked, we begin to bear fruit. So when you start bearing fruit, the blessing comes upon you. So one of the ways to receive the blessing is to start bearing fruit. People who receive the word of God every Sunday, every midweek, Holy Ghost services, and they are not bearing fruit. The Bible said those people, they give God tongues. They give God chuku chuku. People that give God chuku chuku, they can never receive blessing. Do you know in this house, like we are receiving the word of God now, not everybody will receive the word of God. Go back and bear fruit with the word. Some people receive the word of God and they give God, you know, problem in return. They give God unfaithfulness in return. They give God pride in return. Those kind of people, they can never receive the blessing. So the Bible is saying, if you want God to keep torrenting you with blessing, keep bearing fruit. Keep bearing fruit. Keep bearing fruit. The more fruit you bear, the more blessings you receive. Are you with me at all? So if you are not bearing fruit, you don't qualify for the blessing. It's a very simple word. Listen. I had read Bible for over 17 years. I never saw it like this. That your blessing is tied to your fruit bearing. You see, people who are not ready to catch a new revelation and run with it, they can never be blessed. And anybody that is not willing to learn, you automatically become lean in your destiny. So revelation is vital. So what fruit is God talking about here? What kind of fruits do I have to, you know, bear so that God can bless me? I won't go into the nitty-gritty because I took time. If you didn't attend midweek service, that's your own cup of tea. But I took time to teach on the fruit every child of God must bear. Let me touch the surface. The first fruit you must bear in order to carry the blessing is the fruit of repentance. Somebody shout, fruit of repentance. Shout it, fruit of repentance. Give me Matthew chapter 3, verse 8. Let me run through this very quickly. In 10 minutes, I'll be done. Bring forth what? Therefore, fruit. Bring forth fruit. Go back. Matthew 3, verse 8. Bring forth fruit. That is what? So, the evidence that you are a bona fide child of God is the fact that you are changed. Are you with me at all? Every one of us seated here, the reason why you know you qualify for a blessing is because you have stopped your old lifestyle. You have changed. The blood of Jesus has snatched you from the kingdom of darkness into the kingdom of his dear son. So the evidence that you have changed is the fruit of repentance. You no longer go to the beer parlor. You have stopped drinking golda. You have stopped drinking beer. Are you with me at all? You have stopped drinking Pink Lady, cognac. You have stopped it. If you are here and you are still drinking beer and pito, my dear, you can never carry a blessing. You are still chasing people's husbands. I'm coming to the consecration part now. Because it's the month of blessing and consecration. You are still chasing people's husbands. You are a classical psychedelic prostitute. I've said it before. There are two kinds of prostitutes. Ordinary prostitute and classical psychedelic prostitute. An ordinary prostitute, any dick and hurry can just come and lego. Madams in wheelchair will come and enjoy. Native doctors will come and enjoy. They are by the roadside. When you drive around East Lagos, you see them there. It will amaze you that they are believers here. They may not be ordinary prostitutes, but they are psychedelic prostitutes. They are the ones that say, he's my boyfriend, so we are going to spend time in the hotel. You see, those ones, they are not stationed like the ordinary one. No, they are not stationed. They go there once in a while. They are classical prostitutes. He's my boyfriend. He's my boyfriend. They are eating you anyhow. You have turned your reservoir into a supermarket. Biabanwa TBD. TBD. So all your ice cream or your name. Biabanwa TB. The evidence that you are bearing the fruit of repentance is when you quit that life. You are dating a man. He tells you, if you don't sleep with me, it means you don't love me. Tell him you are a foolish man. Tell him without apology. The man tells you, if you don't sleep with me, it means you don't love me. Tell him you are a foolish man. Why? Because love endures. When you love somebody, you are willing to wait. Eh? The man says he doesn't love you because you are not sleeping with him. You are saying, oh baby, don't leave me. Okay, touch me. Touch me. Don't enter. Just touch me. You see your life. You are a useless girl. I'm preaching. I'm preaching. When I was talking of the blessing, you were jumping. When I entered the consecration, you have a problem. You the man too. Eh? You the man that is touching that girl. Unse wanimu kre ya said yo miye miyano. Miye miyano. Unimse wumpeno. You are just pressing. Oh, pressing. A child of God. It will never happen in house of consecration. Catch yourself from foolish friends. Eradicate yourself from all those frivolous activities. It will not help you. You are changed. You are born again. Tell the young man, if you are not willing to wait, I cannot continue this relationship. You the man, the lady calls you, baby, the weather is cold. The weather is cold. Are you a duvet? The weather is cold. Foolish man, you too, you are going. You are saying, Lord, you know, I love you, Lord. It's not my fault. She needs me. She needs me. The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down. He maketh me to lie down. He maketh me. Open worker. Because who called you now? You are going to lie down. Shame on you. That is the fruit of repentance. That is why in this church, it's a principle. If you are not ready for marriage, don't date anybody. I don't believe in all this boyfriend, girlfriend foolishness. If you are not ready for marriage, don't enter into any relationship. There are some boys who are carrying a Balaam anointing. No matter how strong you are, they can change you. I pray to God Almighty, in this month of consecration, may God give you grace to dump them. I say, may God give you grace to dump anybody that wants you to backslide. Listen, everybody that is born again, that is Holy Ghost, when you are dating somebody, your blood, once in a while, it will boil. You think when I was dating mommy, something was not doing me? Sir, if you are here, and you are not a potential Catholic priest, and you don't have that feeling, you need prayer also. Because one day when you marry, it will become vital. I was a man of God. I was an anointed man of God. But when I'm on heat,
and mommy wants to see me. And I said, honey, come. What's wrong with me? The Bible said, flee. Flee. What do you call? Now we're saying about tongues. What's wrong with you? You are entering the hotel room. 214. No entry. You are knocking. Baby, come in. Kalabosha. You are a very foolish person. The Bible said, flee. Listen, don't let anybody waste your time. You know what I always tell myself? Sometimes it's almost as if it is the women that suffer. You, the man, too, you suffer. Keep yourself pure. You, the man, keep yourself pure. You should be able to say, 30 years of my life, 25 years of my life, I have not known any woman. It's possible. It's possible. Even if some people have leg, not one, not two, not three, not five, I know you have graduated to 10. They have all legged you. Change from today. Let the fruit of repentance enter your life. Tell yourself, no more. No more. No more chukuchuku. No more prosconios. If you don't change, by the time you marry the real husband, you enter ShopRite. You see Johnny. Just after you saw John, you see Reagan. Just after Reagan, you see Pius. And your husband will be wondering, why are you dodging all these people? My dear, it's not her fault. Those are past customers that she's identifying in the supermarket. This month, some people have told themselves, by for this year, I will sleep with you before the year. I will sleep. You can preach. I will sleep. Hey, who do you preach? You better. Who do you preach? You better be and fire. Oh, congrats, sending the message. Baby, I love you. And yes, for you, it's paining suffer. Paining me. You can never carry blessing. Congratulations that you are changed. Congratulations, after tonight you are changed. Tonight the word born again will be evident in your life. The second fruit is the fruit of the Spirit. Galatians chapter 5. Let's read from verse 22 quickly. Galatians chapter 5. But the fruit of the what? The fruit, singular, not plural. The fruit. So, in one fruit, you have all these things. Love, joy, peace, long-suffering, gentleness, goodness, faith. Continue. Meekness, temperance. Against such, there is no law. So, the second fruit you must exhibit is the fruit of the Spirit. Love, peace, long suffering. All these things are vital. I took time and handled one of them. I handled it one after the other in my midweek service. Let me teach you the last one. Then we pray. The third fruit. So everybody that has the fruit of the Spirit, we must see love. We must see long suffering. We must see meekness. Eh? These days, people, when somebody says he's anointed, we equate it in the same column as pride. When people are anointed, they can't be humble. And we must walk full. Most of the people who are proud in this generation are men of God. Pride. And you know that the group of people too are very proud. People who are broke. Poor and proud. Because I don't see why at this level of my life I should be proud. What am I that God didn't make me? A man can receive nothing except. Paul said, we are what we are by the grace of God. So you have no business being proud. For what? For what? For what? All of us, when the day comes, we'll go. You won't carry. This is my chair. It's sweet. I know you want to sit here, but don't try it. This chair. Even if I go, I won't carry it. When rapture takes place, you can occupy. That's okay. You can come and sit down. You know, yesterday in the hotel,
It rained. That asked Matthew, the thunder. In the morning, Macho was looking for me. He knocked, knock, knock. And I'm saying, Macho, can we call you one cabbage? Thunder be over. It me boom. Now you must show. I remember years ago there was one like that in my house. When I heard kukurukuru, you know who I went to look for? My children. When I saw they were intact, I said, thank God, we are still here. Uncle had a free ticket. The last fruit. Is the fruit of souls. The fruit of what? Your dividends in heaven is marked by the souls you win daily. Listen, you want God to bless you, but you are not a soul winner. You are very egocentric, very selfish, very self-centered. You are not preaching to anybody. You were coming for Holy Ghost service. There were people in your area that deserve blessing, but you couldn't carry them into the service. People who don't have this fruit of soul winning, they can never be blessed. Are you with me at all? Give me Matthew 28 verse 19. You have to become a soul winner. Tell somebody, become a soul winner. Become a soul winner. Anybody that loves souls, God will bless your life. Because it's the heartbeat of God. If you are not winning souls, listen, if you still have people in your family, you have a certain brother who is not saved. You have a certain sister who is not saved. What are you doing about that brother? Hell is real. Heaven is real. Are you with me at all? Let God use you to snatch somebody from going to hell. Am I talking to somebody at all? Go ye therefore and teach all the nations, baptizing them in my name, in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Ghost. Go everywhere. My daughter, you see, when you have a blessed daughter, you are happy. Hey, oh yeah. Years ago, nobody called me daddy. Somebody's calling me daddy. Opportunity. Tell somebody, become a soul winner. Become a soul winner. Become a soul winner. When you start winning souls, God will give you blessings. I'm telling you. Listen, listen. Even if your prayer is small, but you are a soul winner, God will bless you. Tonight, may grace and the appetite for souls blow upon somebody. When next we hold the Holy Ghost service, that will be the first one in January. You will not come to this meeting alone. The grace of soul winning will come upon you. You will pull people to the house of God. Receive that anointing. Receive that grace. Somebody shall fire. So if you want God to bring the blessing, you need these three things. The fruit of repentance, the fruit of the Spirit, and the fruit of souls. Stand to your feet. Lift up your two hands. Lift up your two hands. Say, my Father, my Father. Shout it, my Father, my Father. Tonight, as my hands are lifted, I decree and declare, let the Spirit, the power of the blessing come upon me. Say, my Father, in this month of consecration and blessing, let the blessing of the Lord that maketh rich come upon me.
Come upon
now.
Now.
Clap your hands and begin to pray.